Fourscore ago, in the land of Lincoln, Mary M. was born.
Fairy tales can come true, it can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams. And life gets more exciting with each passing day. And love is either in your heart or on the way. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young at heart? For as rich as you are, it's much better by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you derive out of being alive. And here is the best part, you have a head start if you are among the very young at heart. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young at heart? For as rich as you are, it's much better by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you derive out of being alive. And here is the best part, you have a head start if you are among the very young at heart.
Hi, Miss Perilli. Happy birthday. I'm making this video because they asked us to make videos for you for your birthday. I can't believe you're only going to be turning 80. It seems like you should be turning 50. But I'm 57, so that's probably a little weird. So anyways, I just wanted to say happy birthday and thank you for all the help that you've given me over the years, getting through two masters and a PhD. So, you know, we like have all sorts of education under our belts. So once again, happy birthday.
Hey, Ms. Perilli. Of course, I'm late getting this video in. I'm having a hard time trying to fix it so it makes me look smaller. It ain't happening. But I am so honored to be able to be a part of this wonderful milestone. You've always been such a positive and a bright light in people's lives, especially mine. I can still remember when we had kids in class and they were giving up, like they just gave up. And you were always pushing them, saying, you can do this. And you had the patience of Job, because couldn't be me. But you had the patience of Job. And you already know how much I love you, and I wish you the best and the most blessed years to come. Happy birthday. Sending hugs and kisses.
Happy birthday, Mimi.
Happy birthday.
80 wonderful years of loving family and really, really, really good times. Thank you for all the stuff that you do for us. And we definitely hope that you have a wonderful day and many more to come.
Yay.
Yay. Yay. Happy birthday.
Ode. Mary M., wishing you a very happy birthday. I wish there was a more personal way in which we could do this. Our friendship goes back 40 years when we first met at Akatink, and then we went on and joined each other again at Quandr for many wonderful years. We've had great travel experiences, wonderful get-togethers with friends, and I'm looking forward to many, many more in the future. Happy birthday, my dear friend.
Birthday greetings to Miriam from her neighbor, Tim. Wishing her the very best birthday from someone who can keep a close eye on her. And if that paper's not up by 10 o'clock, somebody will be checking. Also check to see what else may be going on over there. Some days, I wonder. Anyway, happy birthday to Mary M. and wishing her many more.
Hi, Mary M. John and I join you from our house in Reno, Nevada on this very special round number birthday to celebrate you, to thank you for the incredible hospitality you always extend to us and your generosity and love over the years. And we wish to offer a blessing on this birthday. And with thanks to John O'Donohue for his contribution and our own additions and amendments, we offer the following blessing.
May the light of your soul guide you. May you be given wisdom to see this as a time of gracious harvesting. May you have the passion to heal what has hurt you.
And may you have great dignity and a sense of how free you are. Above all, may you be given the wonderful gift of meeting the light that is within you. May you be blessed, and may you find a wonderful love in yourself and for yourself. Thanks, Miriam, and happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Hi, Miriam. Happy 80th birthday.
Happy birthday, Miriam.
You know, it has been far too long since we've been able to see you in person, and so we hope you're having a great night celebrating. You know, Burke and I talk a lot about how lucky we are to have such incredible family, and I think what makes it even more special is that so many of you are our friends. And so thank you for your friendship, Miriam, and we certainly wish you an incredible upcoming year filled with happiness, with adventure, with good health, and with lots of visits from family, and hopefully even one from us. Happy birthday.
Happy 80th, Mary M. Go, go, Mary M.
Cheers. Cheers.
Hello, Mary M. Congrats on reaching the new 40. Isn't it Clint Eastwood who said, oh, to be 80 again? The reason this is not a video featuring your dear North Yorkshire friends is not that we are trying to resurrect the delightful British tradition of reading our best wishes telegrams at events such as weddings and birthdays, but rather that we never bothered to replace Bob's cell phone when he retired 20 years ago. Now, back to the important stuff. When are we all going to have lunch at Betty's? Or would you rather get lost in Prague again? Perhaps another trip to Vectorsbach, or even taking the night train to Berlin would really be the thing. You know that it all can be easily arranged. Maybe you would prefer doing something new in the Ukraine. How about it? We know that you're up for it. Here's wishing you the very best birthday ever. Hope yours is a Grand Cru champagne or at least a Tanqueray G&T. Much love, Elaine and Bob.
All right. Well, Mary M., we're both turning 80 this year, but you're beating me to the punch. So I just want you to know how happy I am for your celebration. And you haven't been over here, I don't think. I don't know. I guess you did see my new car when we went to Chincoteague. But I've just come from playing tennis. So I'm putting my tennis racket in my new car that's still there. I haven't crashed it yet. And I just want you to know that I want to wish you the happiest birthday ever. And I'm going to New York for my birthday, the 21st of February till the 28th, to see some plays. So happy birthday, sweetie. I wouldn't have ever been the teacher I became without you. Love you.
Happy, happy birthday, Mary M. Hope you have a great celebration.
Happy birthday, Mary Emily.
Take care.
Hi, Miriam. Happy birthday. My goodness, you're joining the rest of us in our 80s here, and I have so many fond memories of our times together and your beautiful children when we first met in 1969. And Matthew, I hope I have the year right, was born that year. And beautiful little Lisa, and then came Jenny. And I have recipes that are dog-eared, that you're just the best cook in the world. And I wish for you many, many more happy birthdays. Happy, happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Maryam. Look forward to seeing you sometime soon. Have a great day. We love you. Bye-bye.
Hi, Maryam. Happy birthday. I've written a little poem that I'll read. I'm not Robert Frost, so please be patient. Here it goes. There, I see it. Over all the years, Maryam has been a part of my adoptive family. A look at her creativity began with a beautiful shard saved for a usable table. And as all DIY books and shelves of Who's Done It Before can attest, our plans of purl and knit, patch and paint become an urban fable. Yet, in Maryam's world, there I see it. The rooms of smaller desks filled with little people eager to include a broader view of life and space end to end allowed for literary creation. Written in the words and pages bound with stories of children's tribes belonging came the feather dance and call to honor the rite of passage to a Cheyenne nation. And in Maryam's world, there I see it. Moving and traveling from country and base, found home once settled in a U.S. town, where friends and family gathered and grew. Easy talk with caring words were given to each. And even strangers knew how sincere kindness and intelligent talk could appear at once, with Ben Kingsley sharing a flight of direct connections of ideas and Mary M. showing celebrity within her reach. So in Mary M.'s world, there I see it. Happy birthday, Mary M.
Hi, here we are at the beach, one of your favorite places, and not just any beach, but the beach in Sarasota where you brought us as kids. I have many happy memories of travel with our family, mostly to cultural places, the highlight being Herbert Hoover's boyhood home, and I'm grateful for all the things that you've taught me.
Maryam, life is mostly luck. I've been very fortunate to know you for 31 years. You've become an example for me in the same way as my mom and dad. 80 years young, I look forward to the adventures to come.
Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy
love
birthday.
You. I was at QRC from 79 till 90, the last 8 years as principal. How fortunate to find Mary M. through Karen Latta towards the end of my years at Quander. Such a professional, astute, caring teacher who worked magic with so many students over so many years. After her full-time career, she became, I believe, the most available and terrific substitute teacher ever. I would check yearly, asking when she was truly, truly going to retire. I wish her the best of birthdays, and I welcome her to the 80s crowd. I cherish her as a friend and hope family and friends will help her to continue celebrating. Love and hugs, Margaret Quayle.
Happy birthday, Mep. We have known each other for 25 years, and we have been through some funny experiences together. From hysterical fiction and those term papers that you gave the kids every year. We've been through adventures where you got me to sign up for classes promising that there'd be interesting men, Lewis and Clark for one, and there never were. We've been to WETA and been unsuccessful with that. You got me to sign up for Italian class, and then you dropped out. And I'm still taking Italian. So that's been an adventure. When we went to Italy, you got us kicked out of Santa Cristina. I mean, you carrying on with that old priest. Good night. He escorted us out. Good. That was really bad. We really got called FOLs in Italy, which was a label that I think that maybe we should be kind of proud of. Now, we have had other adventures in restaurants and shopping that we could be admired for. I have given you permission to buy a necklace in Warrenton. Let's see, I talked you into a pair of diamond earrings at one of the Fairfax flea markets. We never did wear our plaid skirts on 14th Street though, and you know, I'm really kind of thinking the time has come for that. We've bought a lot of clothes that were the same, and many people have mistaken us for relatives, sisters, in fact. My goodness. We just have had fun, and I may have teased you a little bit about your relationship with Abraham Lincoln, but what can I do? It was something I had to share with the world. And fortunately, your family has been so influenced by it. Even your grandchildren know about Abe. And I think it's one of my more shining moments, in fact. Okay, so I'm hoping that we both live another 50 years, even though you're old. Jeez. And so we can have more adventures and be silly. So have a happy birthday. I will be in Firenze when you hear this. So ciao, ciao.
Hi, Maryam. Happy birthday. So glad I could send these greetings virtually. Hope you are having a great day and looking forward to your birthday, and that you're able to see some people, hopefully, these days, as difficult as that may be. But glad we can all get together this way at least and send our best to you. And, you know, there's so many things we could probably say, but certainly from my standpoint, your effort to keep the families together over the years and have visits in Virginia and have visits in Illinois and keep in touch remotely and to see each other over the years has been great. And we've all been able to keep in touch and have good lasting relationships and see concerts together and all that fun stuff. So really appreciate your effort in doing that through the years. It's really helped, I think, all of us. So happy birthday to you, and take care and hope to see you soon.
Hey, Miss Borelli, thanks for fudging my grades through high school so I can graduate. Happy birthday!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Maryam. Happy birthday to you.
Well, we wish you a very happy birthday, and we can't wait to celebrate with you. Happy 80th.
And look at Winter. He's so excited to see you again, Maryam. Yay!
Bye-bye.
Love you. Bye-bye.
Hi, Mrs. P. I just wanted to take a moment to wish you happy birthday. It's a significant one. And to highlight many of the reasons, actually, that we all love you. I personally want to thank you for how caring and how supportive you were during my intern year, and being a mama bear against some of the not so nice people in the program. I don't know if you remember that with Brian. But between you and Colleen, I think I really, really lucked out on my first year of teaching and having the two of you as mentors and colleagues. And I am forever grateful for that, not only as a teacher, but also as a person, because it led into some really nice relationships with you that I greatly appreciate. So I just wanted to say thank you from the bottom of my heart for being present in my life, and to honor that day for you. Made this video and hoping it will go into the pile. Wishing you a happy 80th birthday, Mrs. P. The best to you. See you soon.
Hi, Emma. Happy 80th birthday. I hope that you're going to have a great day, or have had a great day, and have heard from all of your friends. I'm sorry I can't spend much time with you wishing you a happy birthday, because I have to go study for my geology exam. The Northwestern is letting me retake it because I told them I was up all night waiting for a friend of mine to come over and study with me, and she didn't show up until 6 o'clock in the morning. So I get to do my geology exam again, and I have to hurry up and get to TAGS so I can have my lemon meringue pie before my geology exam. One more thing, Maryam, the police are probably going to contact you. They were inquiring this morning about some garden or lawn gnomes that were taken from the south side of Evanston and put on the Knox's front yard. I didn't say that I knew anything about it, but I thought that I should tell them that you may know something about it. Anyway, sweetheart, love and adore you. Happy birthday.
Go.
Hi, Mary. How you doing? It's been too long since I've seen you. You were always so generous with your time when we came to Washington, and I want to wish you a happy birthday and, of course, welcome you to the 80 Club. It's about time you caught up with me. So just to say hello to you, and I want to introduce you, or at least tell you I have another friend that wants to say happy birthday, Frank Thomas. Your old buddy from the Chicago White Sox wants to say hello to you. So,
1, 2, ready, go!
This is your birthday. Happy birthday to ya. This is your birthday. Yeah, we're gonna have a good time. This is your birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Maryam.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Maryam. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Mrs. Pirelli. Thank you so much for being a friend to the Owens for how long?
40-some years.
God bless you. God bless you, actually. Happy birthday.
Oh, I am up. Maryam, I can't say enough about our friendship. It's been a great one for, like we say, almost 45 years. And it's just one of the great friendships of the world, as far as I'm concerned. And I wish you the very, very best, the best in health, the best in everything. And I love you.
Okay, pal, it's my turn. I just want to tell you that I've just loved you from the very beginning. Our friendship has had some ups and some downs. Not really our friendship, but we've gone through some ups and downs. And the best thing that ever happened was when I saw you coming into the Officers Club at Fort Bragg. And I said, I bet that's her. And the people I was with says, you're crazy. But I went to your table and introduced myself, and it was you.
So. Did you pay their bill?
No. Okay. She didn't even pay ours. What the heck? Okay, pal, I love you. Have a great day.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday
again.
How wonderful to take time out to celebrate really an extraordinary woman, a great sister, a wonderful mother, caring, loving and caring mother, wonderful grandmother, I'm sure an amazing teacher and truly an amazing friend. I'm grateful for the wonderful memories in France and in Spain and in Jerusalem together, wonderful discussions. I feel blessed that you're in my life. What a great blessing you are for all of us. God bless you. Many more wonderful, healthy years. Happy birthday.
Happy 80th birthday, Maryam. We love you. Lots of memories. I think of all the time you guys have traveled to Chicago over the years and going to the beach and Cub games and all the mischief and all the swigging that we did as kids. But you were always there to add comfort and a laugh to the situation. So we love you and remember all the memories very fondly. And we did our visit to Washington, D.C. in 2013, and you came out to see us, which we'll always remember. So thanks for doing that. And we got to see Lisa in that same trip. So lots of memories. And 2013, that's when it was. And lots of memories. And another, I think on a more serious note, is you and I had a connection with my godfather, Uncle George, of course, through your love of the Chicago White Sox. So that's another really important element to, I think, all of our relationships. And we love you for that and the strong relationship the two of you had. So I guess anything else, guys?
No, just we love you and hope you have a great day.
Yeah.
Yeah, we love you. Happy 80th birthday.
Happy birthday.
Love you, Maryam. Bye.
Hey, Maryam, it's the Lambricks crew from Arizona. Wanted to wish you a happy 80th birthday. Enjoy the day, and hopefully they have a big party for you.
Happy birthday. Enjoy your day.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Maryam. The best thing about working at Quandr, aside from my friendships with Carlin, is the friendships that I made. I want to thank you for being such a good friend, supporting me, being lots of fun, having all the good times, the laughter that we had, all the stories we would tell about Quandr. Also, I want to thank you for all the help you provided hundreds of the Quandr kids. You taught them how to write an essay. You taught them how to use good grammar. You taught them how to make a research paper. And contrary to what Matt Johnson's father said, English is important. Happy birthday.
Happy 80th birthday, big sister. On this notable occasion, I welcome the opportunity to share some random childhood memories, such as when Aunt Babe found us sitting on the closet floor, smoking a cigarette. You were 4 or 5. I was 4 or 5, you were 8 or 9. I wonder if Aunt Babe ever told Mother and Dad. I'm grateful for the fact that I had Officer Sims as my driving instructor. This was due to your having hit a boulder when making a right turn at a corner. Dad was giving you lessons, so Dad hired someone to take over the responsibilities, and we both passed the tests. Then there were the parties, some very proper, like our combined high school and grade school graduation party. And then there were some others, such as the party that you and your friends threw in our rec room when Mom and Dad were out of town. All that beer. Then there were the little sister issues. A perfect example. When you were a senior at Northwestern, you lived in the sorority house. If you needed me to pick you up there, and it was a school day for me, you made me wait in the car, not go in the sorority house since I had saddle shoes on, which was part of the restriction that the Duns put on our uniform wearing. Keep in mind, this was before cell phone errors, so I just had to sit and wait. You've always been able to come up with some tasks for me. Again, just to name a few, scraping sandy marshmallows off the kitchen floor in Otto Lane after 2-year-old Lisa's backyard birthday party. Lots of fun in the sandbox. Then there was a toy chest we bought when I was visiting you and Laurel. You were pregnant and couldn't stand the odor, so I got to do the job all by myself. And then there are the ongoing projects, like stripping ivy off your oak trees in your Fairfax yard. I could come up with several others, but it would be boring. Lisa's instructions were to film a short video, so I don't want to go on and on, although I could. Enough said. God bless you and have a happy, happy. Love, Kate.
Hey, Mrs. Pirelli. Kelly here from Seattle. Just wanted to wish you a happy, happy birthday. And just tell you kind of what I'm feeling about our family's relationship with you for so many years. You know, I can't even express how much you've been there for our entire family, and then actually how much you've been there for me over all these years. It's just such a special relationship we have with you. So I just wanted to tell you how much you mean to me personally, and we all love you so much, and we're so happy that we can send you these videos and wish you well for today and for a long, long time. And actually, I was thinking yesterday when I was at work, I've been with Delta for, I think, 38 years now. And it occurred to me that you actually gave me my first job. You entrusted me with your children, and I was able to train them, Lisa, to actually do the babysitting job for me, to little Matthew to answer the door at 4 a.m. when you rolled in, and I had him trained. So I actually was like, hey, that's a pretty good deal for me. And I have always kept your first paycheck. So here it is, right here. My first paycheck ever was from you. Here it is, 50 cents, and I still have it. Anyway, love you, happy birthday, and enjoy the day. Mwah.
Happy birthday, Maryam. I'm here having a cocktail to celebrate this wonderful event. I only wish I could be with you. I'm blessed to have a friend like you. Even though we're miles apart, I could pick up the phone tomorrow. And it would be like we had talked yesterday, or you were in my next door neighbor, talking about our families, our adventures, and even events of the world. We have had wonderful times together. We started making our memories in Maryville Marywood first, then Maryville. Then we went to Rome. We were in each other's weddings, married life, now retirement. And we're not done yet. Take the time today to celebrate this special event and then get back to making more memories that we can share. Maybe on our 90th, we should go back to Rome and look for our names that we carved in that bathroom. Just an idea. Okay, have a wonderful celebration. I love you. Cheers.
Happy birthday, Maryam. So in honor of your 80th birthday, we decided that we'd come up with 80 things that we love about you and swiftly decided that that would be too long a video. So instead, we've come up with 8, one for every decade. Number 1, we love how welcoming you are.
Number 2, we love your unspoken apples to apples bond with me.
Number 3, we love how interested you are in the world. Few people know as much about a wider range of things as you.
And number 4, we love how open-minded you are.
Number 5, we love when you shout, "Get him!" at anyone playing the Chicago Bears.
Number 6, we love your commitment to anything Abraham Lincoln.
Number 7, we love how playful you still are.
And finally, number 8, we love how kind you are and how welcoming you've been.
Happy birthday,
Maryam! Hi, Maryam. Here it is, Sherry Rupi. 80 years old, Maryam. Well, guess what? We're all in the same boat, so that must make you feel good. I want you to notice my shirt. And Maryam, I still remember the story you shared with all of us many years ago about a friend of yours who had gone to a Goodwill store, and in the pile of clothes, she found a Marywood uniform. We all thought that was so fun and so many laughing moments at that time. Maryam, I wish you a wonderful birthday, and my regret is that we haven't been able to see each other that often. We've always depended upon Bridget having her wonderful get-togethers. So again, happy birthday, Maryam. Hope to see you soon.
Hi, Maryam. Happy birthday. It is scary to send you visual birthday greetings. There are few things I fear more than speaking in front of a camera. However, we do want to let you know how much your friendship over these past 40 years has meant to us. It is hard to believe how long it has been, since none of us seems to have gotten any older.
It's also been our pleasure to watch Lisa, Jenny, and Matt grow up to be such wonderful people. It's great you are right next door. This way we are able to constantly see each other, talk, and share news and views and whatever during the pandemic and before and after. Maggie loves you. She always stops when we pass your house to check if you are outside and say hello. She especially likes it when you give her treats. She knows you're such a soft touch.
Wishing you many, many, many more happy and healthy birthdays. Love, Marilyn and David.
Hi, Maryam. Happy birthday to you. Hope you're having a terrific day celebrating this milestone birthday. And I hope the year ahead has so many great things in store for you, including the White Sox winning some baseball games. Anyway, I hope to see you soon. You take care of yourself. I love you and miss you. Happy birthday. Bye-bye.
Happy birthday, Maryam. It's a pleasure to be able to wish you a great day, sending you lots of love, and also an invitation to visit in Oregon, which I think I've offered before. Maybe it'll happen. Anyway, lots of very, very good memories of Frankfurt and Washington, D.C. You have been such a special friend, and I miss you. So, hope you have a great day full of love and family and a great year of good health and adventures, like coming to Oregon. And here is my gift to you from Oregon, Daphne and Camellias. I wish you could smell these. So is this tempting? Hope it is. Love you. Bye-bye.
Happy birthday, Maryam. I'm so glad I get to help celebrate this big event. Coming up with a few memories to share from over the years is tough. There have been 40 years of wonderful memories. I cherish every single one of them. I will forever be grateful that you and my mother conspired and I brought Lisa that violet on her 16th birthday. It has obviously changed my world, but created many, many more memories over the years for our families. Thank you for everything you've done for me. You've been there a lot. I appreciate it very much. And I look forward to celebrating with you next time we're together, which I hope is soon. But have a wonderful celebration and happy birthday. Love you.
Hi, Maryam. This is Chicken Talk. And we are here to wish you a happy birthday. We're at a secret, undisclosed location.
Yes, it's very cold here in Chicago, so you know we're...
My hands are literally freezing. Okay.
What?
Nothing. We just wanted to say hi, happy birthday to an educator extraordinaire, an award-winning volunteer, a renowned children's book author, a world traveler, an amateur but darn good nurse, and an indulgent and much loved granny. Have you guessed where we are? And a delusional, diehard White Sox fan. Here we are at White Sox Park. You don't have the sign in there. Get the sign in there.
Oh my God! Where is the sign?
Okay, well, you're just going to have to take it on our word.
There's the sign. We're at White Sox Park. It's freezing out here.
And we gotta go.
It's windy and cold.
Okay, happy birthday, honey. Love you.
Happy birthday.
Bye.
Bye.
Mary M., oldest and best friend. In fact, everybody wanted to be your best friend. But I always flattered myself that perhaps I was your best friend. How can I say happy birthday adequately to somebody who's been my friend for over 70 years? Maybe we knew each other a little bit in preschool because we went to the same preschool. But when we really got to know each other was when I moved to Park Place in fourth grade. I spent so much time at your house, so much time playing with you, playing with Barney, playing with you, Kate and Barney, playing at the Willard School with Jay, Jost, and Marsha Moss. Doing things after school. It seems like I was constantly at your house. And when you moved to Otto Lane, I saw even more of you. And your dad always had that case of Cokes, that wooden case of 6-ounce Cokes in the garage, and you would offer me one, and we would sit down in your den for hours and talk. So many memories of high school, chasing the boys down to Northwestern Pier, multiple dates that I went on as the third wheel with you and Jim Thompson in his car. I can't capture the memories, but they go all the way through to the present, to you typing my papers in college in Rome. And thank you very much for the A that you got me. I never would have gotten it without you, because I could never type near as fast and as accurately as you. I hope you have a wonderful birthday with your family. I hope it's the best ever. I hope this finds you in terrific health. I wish you many, many more years, and I want to get up there to see you real, real soon. I think it's wonderful of your kids to put this together. I just hope you have a great birthday and it's a happy, happy 80th. And then I've got one too coming up, but you'll always be older than I am. I love you. I love you so much, best friend. Have a happy birthday. Bye.
Hi, Maryam.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Maryam. Happy birthday to you.
We love you, honey. Happy birthday. Lo, these many years we've been friends. I hope it's a really special day and year.
We're all having a big year this year, and you're having a bigger year than anybody. Hope you have a great birthday party celebration with your family and your friends that can be with you.
We wish we could.
That's right.
Come see us, honey. Okay. Yeah. Love you, Miriam.
Love you, Miriam. Happy birthday again.
Happy birthday and cheers, Miriam. We want to thank you. What's that? Oh, you don't know who we are? Hello, it's Delium.
Happy birthday, Miriam.
Happy birthday. We love you. Thank you for all your years of love and support and laughter. Love you.
Happy birthday, Miriam. I think Lisa sent us out and asked us to make these videos. And when she did that, I thought of, first of all, that we've known each other for over 30-some years. Started out on the first floor of Quandar, and there was the two ladies from Accutink, me and you and Karen, and then me. So that's three rooms on the first floor. There's a couple more rooms, but we pretty much had the first floor tied down. I might have been across the hall from Karen, or I went down to where the clinical suite is when I took the music job. But it was us then, and since then, a lot of our lives revolved around Quandar. Getting to know you, I've gotten to know somebody who is a very caring person, who does things for other people, and you are good with advice, and you make people like me want to do things better or more conscious for others. I guess I'd say I'm having trouble coming up with the right words, but I'm not getting religious here, because it's going to be pretty obvious when I say what I say, but I think you've maybe kind of look at things in a way, and I mean this in a humorous way, but there's like two kinds of guilt. There's Protestant guilt and there's Catholic guilt. I'm Protestant, you're Catholic, but I've known a lot of Catholics all my life, and so I'm not big on the separation of religions and stuff, and you know, Catholics, one of the best things Catholics used to do was eat fish every Friday, and I like fish, so I'd be at my Catholic friends' houses on Friday. So anyway, to explain the type of guilt, the Protestant guilt is fire breathing stuff, and you know, whatever you did, you likely are stepping in a big hole and you're just going to go to hell. You know, I imagine that's partly what a lot of my relatives think of me. So I kind of step away from that. But then Catholic guilt, a lot of times it will develop when you see somebody do good and they can be a good example to you, and then you look at them and you go, my gosh, I wasn't thinking what they were thinking, I was thinking something evil. So in that way, you set a really good example for me. I will say that this is particular, a type of Catholic guilt I've had when it comes to you, and I'm not coming out with it now, is I'm very careful how I would mention the word Costco, because when I did, you would always ask me to pick you up a case of water. and maybe I just wasn't feeling it. Picking you up a case of water is a small thing for all the things you've ever done for anybody else. And your kids know about this guilt. I know they know about it because you're very good with the right thing to do, and people just naturally should want to do things for you because you're so good to everybody else. So anyway, the first thing I thought about when this video, when I was supposed to make this video, stuff for Lisa, was that, was the water deal. And I haven't bought you any water for a long time. So I went to Costco Saturday, and one of the purchases I was gonna make was a case of water for you. So I'm walking around Costco, my phone rings, and who is it? It's Maryam Pirelli, calling to wish me a happy birthday. And I'm sitting there going, this is a sign. This is a sign, you know, what can I say? God, I'm gonna do the right thing. I'm buying her a case of water. So I am bringing you a case of water. Here it is right here. I didn't remember if you like the big ones or the little ones. This is the big ones. But if you want the little ones, let me know, because this is the first case. You're gonna have to make room in your garage. I'm gonna get you 8 cases of water, one for each decade. So just let me know what size. This is the first one I'm gonna bring. I thought about buying all 8 of them. God, they're heavy. I don't know if you want this sticking around. I don't know if you want one all the time or not. But let it be known on my watch, Maryam Pirelli will not dehydrate. So have a happy birthday. I'll probably see you very soon. And guys, whoever watches this video, so I hope this all makes sense. But Maryam, understand that I know. Happy birthday again.
Happy birthday, Maryam. This is certainly a wonderful occasion. So I want to wish you happy birthday, but also give you some helpful tips because I have preceded you to the big 8-0. That's the big secret. We're admitting it by a few months. So anyway, we have this walker. You might not need it right now, but we all have these things in our garages. Canes, optional, but very helpful. And you might want to consider some of these products, medicated patches, Australian Dream, Voltaren. A knee brace is very good. Black, good color. Because these things are lethal. No, we've got to get rid of these things. Absolutely not. And instead, what we need are firm shoes, laces, good grip. If you want something a little fancier, something like this will do. Got our tests ready. Keep them handy. Never know. And back patches, just in case that little ache comes up. Pill boxes. One might not be enough. You need two. And in the end, we say with our special Alamo coffee cup, happy birthday, Maryam.
Happy birthday, Maryam, from Gal and Chris. You were my mom's closest friend, and now you've become mine and also my substitute mom. I will be toasting you with Prosecco and wishing you a healthy and happy 80th birthday.
Hi, Maryam. It's Mary here, wishing you a very happy birthday. It's hard to believe that we're going to be 80. It just doesn't seem possible. I think we met when we were in second grade at St. Athanasius. So here we are, and I haven't seen you in a while, and I hope we see you in the summertime. Give me a call sometime. Happy birthday.
Hi, Maryam. I'm sitting outside of my first house, and I've got the dogs locked up inside so I could concentrate on wishing you a happy birthday and many more. It was great to see you the other day. right. Happy birthday.
Happy 80th birthday, Maryam. In case you don't recognize this old face, it's Rindy Chamberlain from Tampa. I have so many fond memories of when you were here in Tampa. I remember us going to Lowry Park Zoo with the kids. And I remember one crazy adventure we had when we took Lizzie and Jenny in their strollers to the closing of a department store in downtown Tampa. When they opened the doors, we almost got trampled. I was very sad when you left Tampa. I wish you the best, happiest celebration with your family for your 80th birthday. And hopefully maybe one day we can see each other again. Happy birthday, Maryam.
I hope you have the best birthday in the world.
I love you, Mimi. I hope you have a really happy birthday.
Have a wonderful birthday. You deserve it.
Happy birthday, Mom. Thank you for being the best mom in the whole world. I love you so much.
One, two.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mimi. Happy birthday to you.
We love you, Mom.
Many more.
Love you.
Happy birthday, Maryam. Wish we were together. Have a great birthday, and let's plan a trip. Sue.
Yeah, that's okay.
Oh, Lord.
It's me again. I realized I didn't mention Jenny in my video to you. And that's because when I was babysitting, confession, I never saw her. If I would have seen her, that would have cost you this amount. So anyway, happy birthday. Bye.
I wish I could get the sign in again.
Happy birthday to you.